Welcome to the BuildBlock installation video series. These videos will cover the basic steps to building your ICF home. Each video in this series will cover specific topics, tips, and techniques for building with BuildBlock insulating concrete forms. This video explores the entire ICF construction process with key steps to keep in mind when planning your project. The first step in planning your ICF project is to review your site. Consider how your home will sit on the site, the elevation, solar gain, drainage, and prevailing winds. When all permits are in place, begin by excavating to prepare the site for footings or slab-on-grade construction. Check plans for accurate block dimensions and map out the project to prepare for the footings and foundation. The footings are the base for the entire project. Success depends on getting it right from the beginning. Begin with forming footings as specified by local codes or engineering based on your local soil conditions. After all formwork is completed, next properly place reinforcement in the footings. Before pouring footings, a pre-pour inspection may be required. Check with local code officials to be sure. When placing concrete in formwork, make sure concrete is consolidated correctly to eliminate voids or honeycombing. Work methodically with your team to ensure a consistent foundation and avoid challenges later on. It is critical that the footings are level, or this will be a challenge during every step of the project. Taking care here will make all the difference. Place vertical reinforcement into the footings as specified by using the prescriptive method, local codes, or site-specific engineering. Snap square lines on footings to mark block placement. Now is a good time to gather all necessary materials and prepare to stage materials to begin stacking walls. With your material gathered, stage blocks, rebar, and tools inside your project at least 6 feet back from the walls, leaving room for the bracing and alignment system, and plenty of space to work. Begin stacking at a corner, and work in one direction toward a common seam, usually above an opening, if possible. Remember to place horizontal rebar as specified by local codes or site-specific engineering. At a minimum, place the rebar in the bottom course, another 12 inches from the top of the wall, and in the remaining thirds of the wall. Remember to place your rebar in corners as well. If it is necessary to cut blocks, cut straight and square using the molded-in cut lines on the block. Place cut blocks, if possible, above windows and doors to simplify the build. After 2 to 3 courses have been stacked, level and plumb the wall by shimming and trimming the wall where necessary. Spot glue only to hold blocks in place and continue stacking. Remember to reverse corners every course to create a staggered running bond to lock the wall together. Working off foot planks on the bracing system makes stacking the top of the wall easier. Make sure an OSHA-approved bracing system is used and all safety precautions are taken. Place bracing as specified and secure appropriately. Pre-make window and door bucks and place them in the wall when ready. This is an example of V-Buck, a vinyl bucking product. Other types include ICF bucks, treated lumber, and other wood products. Make any service penetrations for plumbing, electrical, and telecommunications before pouring concrete. Continue placing horizontal rebar as specified by site-specific engineering or local codes. Stagger the placement to create a chase for vertical rebar. Carefully place vertical rebar into the chase created by the staggered horizontal rebar placement. This will ensure that all rebar stays at least 3/4 of an inch away from any foam. Before pouring your project, utilize the pre-pour checklist in the BuildBlock installation and technical manual. Ensure you have all supplies ready and your team knows the plan. Begin pouring in 4-foot lifts. This will relieve the pressure as the concrete sets slightly and continue working around the project without stopping until the top of the wall is reached. Vibrate each lift with a 1-inch low-impact vibrator to ensure good concrete consolidation. When topping off the wall, make sure the wall is full and level after the concrete is consolidated. Place anchor bolts or straps correctly. Make sure the wall is straight, level, and plumb before the concrete sets. When finished, make sure the top of the wall is clean and flat. Stay off the alignment system until the concrete has set completely. Continue checking the wall after the pour to make sure that nothing has shifted. These basic steps will help you successfully build your ICF project. More videos in this series will cover these topics in more detail. These videos are a companion to the BuildBlock Installation and Technical Manual available for download at buildblock.com or a hard copy for purchase in the My BuildBlock store.
For more information about BuildBlock ICFs, visit buildblock.com and visit our YouTube channel, youtube.com/buildblock.